For this construction, I'm going to show you how to copy an angle. Now first I'm going to draw an angle. Label it angle A. There you go. And I use a straight edge just to draw a random angle. It didn't matter how large the angle is. This is an acute angle, less than 90 degrees. So I'll show you how to copy an angle. First thing you do is you want to mark the point where the vertex of the angle is going to be. Then what you do is you go ahead and draw a ray. Then I'm going to take my compass and I'm just going to put the point on the vertex of my first angle that I'm trying to copy, and then I'm going to carefully make an arc like that. Okay, what I'm doing is I'm marking how far out I'm going to be placing my compass to finish copying the angle. So what I'm doing here is I'm just kind of using my left hand to hold the pointer in place, and I'm using my right at the top of the compass to just twist it. I could just hold it by the top and twist it, and that will work out fine. See, like that. Okay, now the next step is I'm going to measure the width of the angle with my compass. I put the pointer on one intersection where the arc I drew intersects with the ray of the angle. And then I'm going to adjust the compass until the pencil lead is right on the other ray, like that. See, that's the width that you're measuring with your compass. Remember, you use a compass for measuring. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my compass and I'm going to put the pointy end on the intersection of the ray that I drew first, and then I'm going to make a mark on the first arc that I drew. And what that does is that measures exactly how wide the angle has to be. See, so you're doing the same thing here and here. So you make that measurement. Then all you do to finish copying your angle is draw your second ray, and that ray is going to go from the vertex point that you drew, and then carefully line up your straight edge so it'll go through the intersection. Like that. So that is how you copy an angle. So these two angles, call this A prime, have the exact same measure.